Well, morning, everybody. Happy Monday. Nice to see you all. I hope you all had just the most magical and wonderful bank holiday weekend. How glorious was that weather? And I hope you're feeling rested and ready and energetic, ready for another fantastic week of our virtual summer term together. Now, if you give me a moment, I'm just going to share my screen and we'll start our assembly together this morning. So just here we go. Make sure I've clicked all the right buttons and off we head. Well, firstly, a huge thank you to everybody who got involved in our community history project last week to celebrate VE Day. I was just overwhelmed by the array of fascinating and inspirational stories that were shared right the way across the school amongst pupils and amongst the teachers and staff. Thank you so much to everybody that got involved in supporting that project. And I hope you also enjoyed as much as I did seeing all the fabulous pictures of bunting, fabulous examples of cake being baked. It all looked very delicious. And I hope you all had a lot of time eating it and enjoying parties in your gardens over the course of this weekend. I certainly enjoyed watching lots of the VE Day celebrations on TV on Friday, and I hope you managed to watch a little bit of it as well. I also really enjoyed on Friday evening listening to the Queen's speech, and I was particularly struck by the core messages that came through around community and leadership and resilience. I think they're messages that are really important to us at this time. And I particularly loved this short quote. "Today it may seem hard that we cannot mark this special anniversary as we would wish. Instead, we remember from our homes and our doorsteps. But our streets are not empty. They are filled with the love and the care that we have for each other." And I thought that's a really rather wonderful message, and it echoes fairly perfectly our school values and our beliefs here at Cranford, that we all have a role to play and a contribution to make to the society that we live in. And that's what we've seen so wonderfully on display throughout this virtual start to the summer term. And you've often heard me reflect in assembly about these ideas, the importance of community. I think community seems all the more important now than it ever has before, about generosity of spirit and how that sits right at the heart of school life, and about leadership. I think it's all too easy for us to devolve this idea of leadership as something that somebody else has to do. To be a leader is quite a scary idea, isn't it? And that's maybe what Winston Churchill did in the war, what the Queen was doing on TV on Friday night, or what Boris Johnson does as our Prime Minister. But actually, leadership is about so much more than that. And we've talked a lot in school about this concept of everyday leadership, how each and every day we can all be leaders by the examples that we set, by tackling challenges with a smile on our face and a can-do attitude, by challenging ourselves to try that harder task, to push ourselves a little bit further, by demonstrating generosity of spirit and random acts of kindness, being kind to our families through these times. And that struck me as a really good topic for assembly this week. And I wanted to share with you an amazing example of both of generosity of spirit, of community, and of leadership from our school caterers, Thomas Franks, and from our very own wonderful Chef Paul, who you may be aware has set up a community kitchen in the school's kitchens, and he's been involved in a project feeding and supporting NHS workers. And I'm going to share with you a short video from Thomas Franks and from Chef Paul explaining to you a little bit more about what they've been doing. So just give me a moment.
Good morning, Dr. Raymond and all at Cranford House School. I'm Frank Bothwell, the founder of Thomas Franks, your school caterer. And Chef Paul, the famous Chef Paul, and I, with the kindness of Dr. Raymond and Cranford House, have just this week breached our target of feeding 5,000 frontline nurses food from your kitchen. It's been superb. So I wanted to share that with you, that the whole of the community of Cranford House has been outstanding, and we're all so proud of you. And we're also very proud of Dr. Raymond and his leadership. Thank you, Chef Paul. Thank you, Cranford. Enjoy your assembly.
Good morning, all. Hope you're all well. I'm keeping busy feeding 150 people a day for the local NHS staff, which are doing an amazing job. So we've done just over 5,000 meals now for the last 5 weeks, all doing fresh food every day, So starting at work at 6 o'clock in the morning, normally finished about 1 o'clock, so it's not quite a full day, but 6 days a week. It's been great doing it for a great cause. The NHS are doing a great job keeping us going.
Well, thank you, Frank and Chef Paul. I hope you enjoyed that short video. This gives you a short clip and a short glimpse into what's going on in school at the moment and what Thomas Franks as an organisation are involved in all across the country, trying to feed those that are in need and to support our NHS key workers, who also epitomise those ideas of leadership, of community and generosity of spirit as they look after us all at this time. And that got us thinking in school, how can we help? How can we help Thomas Franks and Chef Paul and get behind what they're doing? And therefore, we'd like to set you some small challenges. Every day this week, we have a challenge for you to complete at home with your friends and family. And every time you complete a challenge, we'd like you to seek some sponsorship. So we're suggesting £1 of contribution for each of the challenges you complete, but don't limit yourself to that. If you want to contribute more, feel free. And I've now got a second video to share with you, which just explains to you a little bit more about what the challenges look like next week.
Hello and welcome to Monday's challenge. Today's challenge is all about face painting. We would like you to paint your faces, or you could paint faces of your members of your family if they'll allow you to, and then put the videos or photographs up on the team page. There are lots of different ideas on the internet, or here are some for you now.
You could be or you could be a pirate,
or perhaps a bunny rabbit.
Do you feel inspired? I hope so. We look forward to seeing your pictures uploaded on Teams. Have lots of fun.
She's going to dress up as today. Can you guess what I am? All those David Walliams fans out there, I hope you've got it. That's right, today I'm going to be Gangster Granny, and I'm dressed up to raise money for a fantastic charity. Why don't you do the same? Go on, go and find something good to put on.
Burpee challenge for you today. How many burpees can you do in 30 seconds? Me and Mr. Morrison are about to go against each other now.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay, 30 seconds.
Oh my God!
What? Right, what did you get?
30 seconds ever. I did 20.
20? I got 30.
You got what?
I got 17.
17!
Yeah, so everyone give it a go. Try and beat our scores and best of luck.
Good luck.
Hope that gives you just a couple of ideas of some of the kind of challenges that are going on next week. So quickly, to recap, Monday, face painting, paint your face, send a picture in to the senior or junior pupil teams. Tuesday, climb every mountain, our stair climbing challenge on Tuesday morning. We'll give you some examples of how many flights of stairs to climb different mountains like Scarfell Pike or Ben Nevis or Snowdon, and would like to see your videos and pictures if you're getting that challenge underway. Wednesday, dressing up Wednesday, dig out your favourite costume and send us a picture of you working at home. Thursday, can you beat Mr. Morrison and Miss Lear in the PE fitness challenge? And on Friday, your own freestyle challenge. Mrs. Lanyon gave you some brilliant ideas there. Not sure I quite fancy the clean the loose challenge, but let's see what you all come up with across Friday. Now, if I unshare my screen and come back to you, there's lots of ways there that we can get behind Chef Paul, a legend in his own lunchtime, involved in a fabulous cause supporting Thomas Franks. Please get involved. Please support this project and also have just the most wonderful week at school. You're doing absolutely brilliantly. Have fun. Keep smiling. And I'll see you all really soon. Take care.